Okay, this is it. We're finally going to scrape a real website. We're not working with dummy data anymore. We've learned enough about Beautiful Soup on its own. Now we're going to connect it with requests, and we're going to write to a CSV file. So what's our task? Well, as I mentioned before in the intro video to this section, scraping is a kind of delicate issue. I don't feel comfortable sending however many thousands of students to go scrape, you know, some well-known website where I could be liable for something that they did, and I don't want to be the person who encourages people to do something that those sites may disapprove of. So we are going to scrape a site that I 100% know we have permission to scrape because it's a site that I've helped make. So this is the blog for Rhythm School. I won't go into full advertising mode, but it's a boot camp that I help out at, and they have a blog that has a bunch of posts on it, and we're just gonna scrape these posts. They're in a very easy to extract format, and all that we'll do is we'll scrape through and grab like the title and the link as well as the date, and then we'll store all of them in a CSV file. So we'll scrape all of them on this page. The URL, by the way, I'll repeat this in the video, it's rhythmschool.com/blog. So whatever we do here, what we do here will apply to other websites that may or may not approve of scraping, but this one absolutely does, so we don't have to worry. So our goal, scrape data into a CSV file. We're going to grab all links from Rhythm School's blog, and then we're going to store the URL, the text inside the anchor tag, and a date. So let's get started. I have a brand new file called blogscraping.py, and let's just get our dependencies in here. So we're going to need to import, well, first thing we'll import is requests, because we're going to need to make a request to this URL. So that's first. Then we're going to get Beautiful Soup from BS4, import Beautiful Soup. And while we're up here, we'll import CSV. So the order of things is that we're going to make the request, get the response back, take the HTML we get back, send it to Beautiful Soup, then navigate through that, extract the info we want, and write it to a file using CSV. It's a lot, but it actually won't take that much code. So let's start with the very simple, let's do response equals requests.get, and then this URL as a string. And let's just start by printing response. And if we just print response, we'll just get a response object. If we want to see the actual body, the stuff that comes back, we need to do .text. Let's just make sure we get HTML back when we run it. And it might take a moment. There we go. This looks good to me. This is all HTML. So you can see it here, and this is not ideal to try and figure out what we want. We could find the articles in here, I'm sure, if we looked hard enough. Looks like here's one of the article. There we go. There's a section heading. Here's a link with a title, and here's a date. But this is not how we want to go about it, because this is very difficult to actually read and kind of understand in this terminal. So what we do instead is go to the URL itself and visit it and open up the developer tools. What we're trying to extract to start is the title. So each title here, we can just find one. They all follow the same pattern. So right click and then go to inspect. And then this opens up the developer tools, and you can see, let me see if I can make this bigger for you. It is an anchor tag. And even before that, you can see each article here, each blog post is enclosed in an article element. So there's a type of an HTML tag called an article. So each one of those, what we're going to want to do is just select all of these articles on the page. And then for each article, we're going to want to select the H4 and the anchor tag inside of that. We'll save the URL. And we'll also save the text inside of there, the title. And then finally, to get the date, you could look in here. Let's see, you could probably right click here. This is one place where the date is stored. And this is pretty common that you might find more than one place to find the date. For example, here it is on the page, but then here is this time element that has a date time set to January 2nd, 2018. This doesn't show up on the page if we actually click on it. Is it showing up anywhere? I don't think so. Nope, it's just metadata that is basically encoded with this article. So we can grab it from here, this is easy. Or we could grab it from here, but this is in a nice date-time format. This is more English formatted. Okay, so that's our game plan. We're going to select all articles, and we'll start there. Then for each article, we're going to select the anchor tag inside the H4. Unless there might be more than one anchor tag, that might be the only one. We'll play around and see. If that's the only one, it will be nice and easy. And then we'll select the href to get the URL, so each link. And then we'll also select the title, as well as the date, which is in div class card. All right, so this process is really common. You have a site you want to scrape. You just have to understand the structure first, because the scraping is just you telling it where to look. Where should your Python code look in the HTML? Well, you have to know first in order to direct it. So back here, we're now going to send this response.txt and send it over to Beautiful Soup. And by send it, I mean we're going to instantiate a new instance. So let's just call this soup equals beautiful soup, and then we'll pass in response.txt. And then remember this sort of annoying thing, html.parser as a string. And we can get rid of this. And then with soup, we should be able to do something like soup dot. And if we want to find all article tags, it's just find all article. So let's save that to a variable called articles, and then just print articles. Okay, so we're requesting this URL. We get HTML back, we give it to Beautiful Soup, we tell it, please parse this, take it from a string, turn it into HTML object, or turn it into objects in Python, and then we can call findAll, one of the built-in methods, on that result of soup, find all articles, and ideally, we'll have them all in a collection. Let's see, let me clear this. Takes a moment. And if we look, all right, we have a list. You can see the bracket down here. And if we scroll way up, there's probably, yeah, there's a lot of text here. Here's the beginning. But you can see we're getting every article as well as all the enclosing information in each article. So here's, this is one article right there. Awesome. Now what we want to do is for each article, let's just start with the title, which as you can see is located in the anchor tag. And then it's the text inside that anchor tag. So because it's the first anchor tag, as well as the, is it the only one? Nope, there's another one here. But it's the first one, we can just call .find rather than find all. So we're going to loop through articles, however you'd like, but for article in articles, let's just print, and we're going to do something like article for each individual one .find an anchor tag. And that's going to give us the whole anchor tag if we print that. See what happens now. All right, so we're getting all the anchor tags. What we want is the text inside. And remember, we saw a method to do that, dot get text as a method. And now, moment of truth. Awesome, look, we're getting all the titles. How exciting. I actually haven't gone through, I deliberately didn't go ahead do this ahead of time and know the solution because I wanted to show the process of identifying the information you want to scrape. So I am very relieved that it worked. Okay, so that gets us the text, that gives us the title. So we could, I don't know, make a variable to start and just call it title equals article.findA.getText. Remember, we're trying to find title. We also want to find the date. And we want to find the href, the URL for the article. Okay, and then we're going to take all of them and add them to a CSV file that we haven't done yet. Next, let's actually go with the href, the attribute, on this same anchor tag. So we're going to do article.find.getText, and then we could do article.find again, anchor tag, and use this syntax to find href, or there's dot adders that we saw. If we just print that, let's see what we get. There we go. It's just full of href. So you could do this dot adders href, but there's a shorter syntax, which is just to directly use href like this. And if we run it now, perfect. So we're now getting each URL. But instead of searching or doing article.find twice, it would be better to just do it in a variable. Like, let's go with a tag equals that, article.find a. And then here we can do a tag.getText. And then same thing here, replace this, a tag href. And now we should just get a list of hrefs. Good, nothing changed. And let's save that to a variable and just call it href equals a tag. Or how about URL? And then we have the last one, which is the date. And remember, the date, if we go back here, is inside the article. If this is one article here, it's not inside the H4, it's not inside that anchor tag, but it is inside this time element. So we can just do dot find time. Always trying to find the time. Very funny. So we can do, instead of a tag, what we want to reference is article.find the time element, the first one. I think there's only one in there in each article anyway. And let's just print what we get. What happens? Awesome. So that gets us this far. And now what we want is the value of the date time attribute, which is exactly the same, or we can use the same syntax. We could do .attrs or just directly access date time as a string. And if I do that now, awesome, we're getting the date. And now let's just save that to a variable. Let's call that date, like that. Perfect. And before we actually go ahead and deal with CSV, let's just do a simple print of title, and then URL, and then date, like this, for each one. And let's just make sure it works. It looks good. So we're getting the title, we're getting the URL, and then we're getting the date. And you can see, you know, these things are, the URL is correct, at least. New Year's Resolutions is the title, and the URL is blog/New Year's Resolutions. And we can just trust that the date is correct because we're working inside the same article. So we're only burrowing deeper into the article, if that makes sense. Everything is collected inside each article tag. So we've actually finished the scraping portion. We've requested the page, we've found the data we want. Now we're just gonna write it to a file. And this will actually be review. So we have CSV, and I'm gonna do it up here. We'll start with opening a file that it doesn't exist yet. Let's just call it blogdata.csv. And we need to open that as a write with write mode as, and let's call it CSV file. And then we need to do writer equals CSV dot writer, or I actually prefer to do from CSV import writer. So we could use a dict writer, but we have our data here. It'll be easiest just to put it in a list, in my opinion. So we'll just do this from CSV import writer, and then we'll say CSV writer equals writer. And then we need to give it the file. If this is confusing, make sure, well, you don't have to, of course, but it would help to go back and rewatch that section. But this is the syntax. We give it a file, call writer, which is the function here that gives us the CSV writer with that file, blog data. And then I just call writer.writeRow. And let's start by writing the headers. So we give it a list, and the headers, let's go with title and link, and then date. And let's just verify, we'll even comment out the requests. Let's just make sure that we end up with a file and the headers are in there. Oh, and it says object has no attribute write row, and that would be because there's nothing called writer. I mean, that's the name of the function, but we need to call it on CSV writer. Hopefully you saw that before me. And now if we look, let's open up the blogdata.csv file. All right, so we have our headers in there. Now all we have to do is actually add in all the data that we've requested. So let's begin by just uncommenting this. And then what we'll need to do is indent all of this code, first of all, so that we're doing it while the file is open, if we're gonna use a with statement. So we wanna do it while it's open. We write the headers, and then we're going to loop through articles. We extract the data we want. And then instead of printing, we're just gonna call CSV writer dot write row. And then we have a list because that's how CSV writer works. We're not using dict writer, and I just pass in our variables. So we have title. We need to match the order we defined up here. So title comma URL is the name I went with, and then date. And the moment of truth, so exciting. What happens? Didn't mess anything up. And sweet. So we have a CSV file now. We've successfully scraped data. I know it's not the most exciting data ever, But just use your imagination, replace this with some juicy, hard to obtain data that doesn't have an API, and you can see how this can quickly become useful. So we've got title, link, and date. Let's just take a look. Here's our first title. Here's the comma, and then the date, or the URL, the link, and then the date. And we grabbed all of this from a web page, making a real request and getting data back. Fun stuff. And if you want an extra challenge, one thing you could try, right now we are only scraping whatever's on the front page, but there are at least, five pages right now, maybe more, I'm not sure. They might truncate how many show up. No, there's five pages of blog posts. And you might want to automate it so that it starts here on this first page and it grabs all of these links because each one of these is a link. And this is where we get into web crawling. So you would, what are these listed as? It looks like they're called page. I think I accidentally clicked on it. Try one more time. You can see, yes, these are spans with a class equal to page current. These are spans. And inside there, there's an A tag that says previous. So we would do something like search for all spans that have class equal to page, then grab that URL. So this is the homepage slash blog, but the next one should be slash blog question mark page equals 3 and 4. And also if you knew that it was just a number incrementing, we could do it programmatically and just have a variable called, you know, counter and keep adding one until we don't get a response, until we get a negative, like a, you know, 404 or something. If I tried to request page 70, then we would stop. And then for each result that we get back, we would then scrape the articles, if that makes sense. So you kind of loop, you get all of these URLs, you figure out which URLs you want to scrape, and then you just loop through and call each one. But to be polite, it's best to put in a delay so you're not going one after another with, you know, a millisecond in between. Anyway, that is a fun challenge if you want to try it out.